swank place. I think you have to make reservations at an Olive Tree or an Olive Garden or something like that. And things were going pretty good, and kind of like about halfway through the main course, you know, she winds up, she pops me one, you know, and I go, oh, God, what can I do with that, you know? And I say, man, I'm really impressed, you know? She goes, you know, her, you're a great provider, you've been, you know, good, good dad. You know, I do feel like we're all those underappreciated single parent. But that's for 25 years of lousy sex. You know, and I'm like, oh, babe, you know, I mean, I know it looks too wild. You know, so I'm sitting there, and, you know, dinner's done, and out comes dessert, and I go, huh. So I wind up, I pop her one back. And she goes, hey, what gives? She goes, I go to her. That's the one that gives. So, fast forward. Here I am at a bar with three Guinnesses. Yeah, such a plan. Anyway, listen, I got a quick briefing, give you kind of a little quick appetites about what's going on the 95th. And maybe I could be loyal to my offer to the rest of the panelists to contribute 5 of my minutes and defer them to Colonel Mike Stout. So, you get that, everybody gets that. I love that. That's the word. Okay, so, real quick. First of all, this is just to let everybody know that we really do exist. We've got a building, and to you, I would tell you, you will see this sign, and you all will. So this has nothing to do with you. If you want to come in, the door's open to you. You can come in anytime, knock on the door. You got my contact information. You're all welcome. You're all part of the community. So this is not for you. This is actually for you to sell out and some other people. They know who they are. Nobody is going to be, you know. So here's my mission statement. Very, very boilerplate kind of stuff. Down at the bottom, it's hard to see, but we have the new press that are out there for the 97th and 98th. Purpose, just to let you know a little bit about what we do. We still have for kind of a contingency force for our nation. That's a big deal. So besides, I believe, providing direct support to soft forces and basically U.S. SOCOM, we also are the nation's civil affairs contingency force, which happened and was exercised this late winter, early spring, and we went in and sent 5 companies as part of that search. A little bit of history. I thought it was kind of neat to, you know, kind of go back a long ways together as an idea, easily as far as 1940 and World War II, and other operations we're doing together. This is what it looked like. The one thing that is sort of unique in our organization, which I'm kind of proud of, is the medical component. I do have vets, public health nurses, and docs in the organization. So if there's any functional specialists / experts in an AC unit, this is one place where I do have that capability. A great team of guys, great team of folks, and AVET's been very supportive of it, making that work. The CA planning team, obviously, is really kind of high-end tactical, more strategic, working stuff in soft space. This is what we look like in the build. The 96 has been around for a long time, and surplus companies in the 96 became the units that would populate and see follow-on battalions, and that was kind of the logic, and still the logic. So that the 96 and 98 right now have over 200 soldiers each, as they're starting to fill the 98th and Colonel Medina, and he has about half his complement right now. And the 91st goes into carrier status on around the 16th of March of 2008, which also will be the date for the activation ceremony. Will be the anniversary for every other battalion that comes online and goes from carrier status to becoming an Alpha unit. And we'll also try and traditionally run through calendars some sort of a function conference around that week. This year we're going to have a conference based on civil reconnaissance that will run from about the 17th, 18th of March until that Friday. I think that's the 21st or the 22nd. We'll finish it with part ceremony to activate the new units and then have a ball that night. And we'll try and repeat what we did last year, invite everyone, different social association, the IOs, the NGOs, and HOs, you know, I'll get used to it. looks like, the only reason I put this slide in here is because I didn't know that this is actually graphic control manager for the team. And so that is the real McCoy symbol used for civil affairs teams in CMOP. No surprises there. Civil reconnaissance is kind of the bread and butter of the team, we'll get to that. And for me, civil information management is the bread and butter task for the CMOPs. This is CMOP. This goes back a long ways, and we've been arguing and debating this, and thank goodness for the likes of Dennis Cahill and a bunch of folks years ago in the book signing process. We got that to be a real thing instead of an ad hoc organization, blah, blah, blah. I've never mentioned about that. But we got that set up. It's kind of, it's working out, I think, very well. And now we're just trying to kind of add the infrastructure and the technology behind it. One of the things that we're working on right now, in my opinion, a kind of common saying in the civil affairs community about working with IOs and NGOs like herding cats, I think a little bit disrespectful. I think it's also a little bit of an indictment on our inability to have the right tactics, techniques, and procedures in place to share information. And I think if we continue to work on improving those protocols, I think some of the other challenges will be chipping away at it. Civil information management, I talked about it. I think it's a way of actually rationalizing what we do for a living and giving support to commander the kind of feedback that he's always been asking for as far as what is the contribution of the civil affairs unit on the ground. And this is really chipping away at it. A lot of moving parts, taxonomy, the way you store the information, the way you repackage it, the way you analyze it. Thank goodness for, I mentioned earlier, but Joe Hash of that SOCON has basically given us a vote of support and helped us and actually became the nomination for the joint testing evaluation proposal this year from SOCON will be joint civil information management. And Joe Marsh has also given us a vote of support. And the Maritime Civil Affairs Group is also on board. So I think we're in the right direction. We'll be soliciting other folks in kind to sign up as sponsors. This idea, and like I said, it's part of rationalizing what we do for a living and getting the protocol under control. These are some of the bits and pieces of it. Right now, we're working a lot with Orion Magic, Atlas Notebook, and ArcGIS. ArcGIS